We're going to talk today about computerized provider order entry. It is our goal in developing our electronic health record to use it as what we're calling a digital mosaic of understanding of our patients. And what that means is that every piece of data that we're putting into our health record is like a tile in a mosaic. And when you look at them all together, you should be able to get a picture of the patient, what's going on with that patient. So how do we accomplish that? Here is a roadmap that I refer to commonly. We put the patient at the center where I believe they belong. And then we have blue tiles around the outside that represent the things that are important to the patient. Then in the green tiles represent the parts or the places in the electronic health record where we're capturing those things that are important to our patients. So today we're focusing on actions and how do we record actions. So in the action box we have computerized provider order entry and we have BMV EMAR, which nursing interventions also fall in a record of our actions. So I'm a physician and I believe that I'm a good physician and I believe that the physicians at this organization are quite exceptional. That's one of the reasons why I'm very committed to this job, because I love working with them. They do a great job. They're good physicians because they spend time talking with their patients and they ask open-ended questions and they do good exams and they order appropriate investigations and they follow up on those investigations and they talk with the patient and the family, and in the end, after they've done all this tremendous amount of work, they put down their plan. And this is what it looks like. And I have to tell you, as a physician, the first time I saw this particular slide, and I have seen many of them, and I think I have the same reaction every time. The first thing that goes through my head is, please God, let that not be one of mine. Because I would be very embarrassed if it was one of mine. And then after I recognize that, thankfully, that is not one of mine, and I have to tell you, this isn't actually a Humber River physician. It's just something we've downloaded off of Google Images. But the fact remains that we all look at it, and there's a bit of a fear. We know that we don't do the best job of writing things down on paper. And it's not because we're not good doctors. It might be due to a combination of different factors. Perhaps it's because I didn't take calligraphy in college, I was taking anatomy. Perhaps it was because my hand was really tired by the end of the day. And let me tell you, it gets pretty tired by the end of the day. Perhaps it was because I was in a rush because I knew I'd spent maybe a little too much time on this patient and I needed to get to the next patient because they all need my attention. There are a lot of different reasons why our plan might look like this, but I think it's fairly universal that we all have the feeling that we'd like to do better. We simply don't have the tools. This isn't cutting it. So, let's just clearly outline the problem. What's the problem? The problem is our orders are not always legible. They're not always easy to access because it's on a piece of paper and the piece of paper resides in the chart. So it's hard to find the chart sometimes. It's just not where you know it's going to be or think it might be. Sometimes things get taken out of the chart or moved and they're just not available. And we are suffering from a hybrid charting world right now where there are things that we look at in the computer, for example, lab results and nursing interventions. There are things that we look for on paper in the paper chart. And we don't know where we're looking because we're looking in two different locations. And what you get is a lot of up and down and really great exercise, but not perhaps a lot of efficiency in our care. And of course, the big thing is that this thing has to be transcribed by somebody, which is a challenge in and of itself. So what is the answer? How can we improve upon this and how can we give the providers the tools that they need in order to get their plan communicated to the care team? And that's computerized physician order entry, and that means, or provider order entry, that means that the providers are going to directly enter their orders into the computer and that order will initiate an action. We're going to go through these benefits in more detail. What we're going to talk about is how this adds to transparency and reflection. And if you watch Why Digital, you'll learn that understanding is very dependent upon two forces of transparency and reflection. We'll talk about how it improves safety and outcomes, how it supports best practices, how it allows us to measure outcomes more efficiently, and how it improves efficiency in general. So why computerized? Computerized because we want to enhance our understanding of our patients, and the way we do that is we have to be transparent about the information that we know. So computerized physician order entry is legible. It's available, it's in the computer. You can access it from anywhere. You don't have to be at the patient's floor next to the chart. You can be on another unit. It's easy to view, and then there's one source for all information. It's not like there's an order over here, and then a few pages later there's another order. It's all in the same place. It's also reflective, and what does that mean? That means that the people who receive the order can acknowledge that they have received an order. We can track where the order is in the process of completion. Other providers and members of the care team can suggest orders to the physicians. So the order will show up in the physician's notice box and they can say, yes, thank you very much. That's a great idea. I'm just going to click that and put my signature, my electronic signature on it. So that's a wonderful way of working together as a team. And it's also an opportunity to access best practice. And we're going to go into more detail about that in a second. So I know a lot of you are probably far more pragmatic than I am, and transparency and reflection seem perhaps a bit nebulous, so we're going to talk some numbers now. And I hope you're all familiar with the Canadian Adverse Events Study by Baker. It was done over a decade ago, and it was quite alarming for all of us. They studied 3,745 hospital admissions in 20 Canadian hospitals. They found that there were 7.5% of acute care admissions had adverse events. 37% of those were preventable, 21% resulted in death. And the most common types of errors, medication errors, that occurred were ones that can be prevented with computerized provider order entry. So here's some good numbers for you here. 100% computerized provider order entry means 0% transcription errors. So this is a really wonderful way that we as an organization can bind together to make sure that we are protecting our patients and improving their safety. So that's great. Hopefully that'll lead to improved outcomes. There are other things that we can do to lead to improved outcomes, and I think as physicians we all accept that that there is substantial proof that evidence-based medicine does indeed improve outcomes. And we would like to bring evidence to the bedside in a timely manner. There are some obstacles with this as well. And this is a picture of a stack of journals, and I think every physician I know has one of these in their house. There's a ton of literature that we have to go through, and I find this personally to be very anxiety-provoking. And I have to say lots of my colleagues have expressed similar concerns, and really there is no wonder. Let's look at some statistics. Every day, there are 6,000 relevant medical articles published. Every day. Which means it's not really surprising that the evidence shows that it takes 17 years for a published clinical guideline, and that is something that we are quite sure is going to help a patient. It takes 17 years to get that to the patient's bedside and have providers ordering it on a regular basis. If a graduate graduates from residency, and let's just assume that they know everything that they need to know, and they say, every night I'm going to read two articles and I'm going to retain the information that I read. At the end of 1 year, they're going to be 1,225 years behind. So I think now I'm probably 12,225 years behind, if not a little bit more. This is daunting. And how does one tackle this? No wonder we're anxious about the stacks of journals in our offices or the online journals that we now have, because there's no way we can possibly keep up. We need a tool, another tool, and we have one. We have partnered with a company called Zinx Health. And Zinx Health is a team of people who scour these 6,000 articles. They rate them based on clear evidence-based medicine protocols. They do summaries of them. They put those summaries then into order sets, and we use their order set templates in order to guide us in the building of our order sets. So when we create order sets as physicians, we've taken a look at this evidence, decided if we want to actually incorporate it into our order set. And when we move to electronic order entry, we can even have evidence links available. So if there's something we would really like to communicate to the physicians because we think it's an important educational point, there'll be a little Z that appears next to the order entry spot. and they'll be able to take a look. Here's a little example of the Z right here. They'll be able to click on the Z and take a look at a review of the evidence. And they'll see the reminder from Zinks of what it is we probably should be doing based on the evidence. It'll go through the rationale, including any kind of guidelines, clear guidelines for care of that kind of patient, and it also presents references. This will happen right at the point that the doctor is about to make the order. So this is a great way to bring evidence-based medicine right to the patient bedside and to help reduce some of the anxieties of sorting through thousands and thousands of journals. The doctor still has to interpret that and decide if it's appropriate for that patient, but they have information available. So we've talked a lot about how we can improve safety and how we might be able to improve outcomes. Let's talk a little bit about measuring outcomes. I think it's pretty commonly known that if you want to improve upon something, probably the first thing you should do is take a measurement so you know where you are, maybe have an idea of where you might want to go. And electronic information sets a foundation for us to be able to gather some data and analyze that data. So we have more opportunities for research and practice improvement. So I know I've talked a lot in the past about problem lists, and we now have several physicians who are entering problems into the problem list. What happens when that occurs is that a clear ICD-10 and SNOMED code is assigned to that problem. So we have all of those problems now in a code. When we have everything else in, now we're getting the medications in, and when patients are receiving the medications, that's going to be in the computer now too. We'll also have, with the order entry, all the nursing interventions in the computer. If we order a specific intervention or a way of doing something on this patient, we can then measure how well we did. So we will be able to run a report and say, everybody who's had this diagnosis, who's had this intervention, had what kind of an outcome. So this is a fantastic way to advance research. Mind you, as we do this, what happens is we get more evidence. More than 6,000 articles being published a day as more and more hospitals go up with electronic charts. So I want to take a little extra time to talk about efficiency. How can computerized physician order entry improve our efficiency? And I think there are some things that are fairly clear. It's removing the time from the physician actually putting in the order or expressing the order to the time that the order is in the computer, because transcription is no longer involved. So we take that time out. It delivers that information from the computer directly to the person it needs to go to, and that initiates an action immediately. Now, it is true that this could potentially decrease our waits for certain tests. I need to use a little bit of analogy here. At this organization and at all hospitals, there are many things that happen on a schedule. So we don't poke patients all day long in order to get labs. We have scheduled times where we do draws on inpatients unless it's a stat. That's not going to change with computerized physician order entry. So I liken that to a plane leaving. The plane schedule is pretty set. You don't get to change that. But computerized physician order entry will remove all of the traffic on the way to the airport. As a matter of fact, it pretty much takes the airport and puts it right where you are, brings it to you. So you're not going to expedite the plane leaving, but you are going to increase the likelihood of getting it there on time. Now, stat orders are a different thing, as we all know. Stat orders happen stat, and computerized physician order entry is a great way of getting into the computer, but it still doesn't remove the need to actually communicate to the rest of your team verbally what's going on, especially in a stat situation. So yes, it can improve efficiency. Now, one of the things I really want to be very honest with to all of the physicians who are looking at this thinking, gosh, we're going to be doing this soon, and you will be by June, you will all be doing this. How is this going to improve the efficiency of your care? And I can tell you, at first, it's not going to feel like it does. It is going to take you more time. And statistics very clearly show that it takes, on average, about 6 months for physicians to get back up to full speed after implementing a full electronic chart. There are some things that physicians can do to expedite that, and that is taking control of their training, and you should be listening to the next steps that we will be giving out over the next month about our training plan. We will be gradually bringing along the physicians to improve their skills using the computer so that hopefully that 6 month time will be shortened and it will feel like they start gaining efficiencies faster than they otherwise would. So why do the physicians want to go through all of this and potentially take some time to learn new skills? They want to because it enhances our understanding of the patients, because it improves safety. It supports best practice and improved outcomes. It allows us to measure outcomes, and it can improve our efficiency in the end.